If you enjoy repairing small engines, rebuilding the top end of an engine, especially on a two-stroke, is something that you're going to come across sooner rather than later. And of all the small steps involved, the one that I see people struggle with the most, and the one that I struggled with the most when I first started out repairing engines, just so happens to be the one, if done wrong, has the worst consequences. On either side of a piston, you'll have a small hole, and inside that small hole, there's a gudgeon pin and a bearing, and they're held in place with what are known as circlips. Circlips are just a C-shaped piece of spring steel, and if you look really closely at the side of a piston, you'll be able to see the groove in which they fit in, and essentially it holds everything to the connecting rod which is inside your engine. And when you rebuild the top of an engine, you take those circlips out, you gently tap the gudgeon pin out, the bearing will fall out, then you put the new piston on, new bearing in, gudgeon pin goes through, and then finally those two circlips get put on either side of the piston. And these small circlips that we've been talking about, they come in many different shapes and sizes. Some of them have two wings either side of the C shape, some of them just have one, but more commonly nowadays you'll find that they don't have any, and those ears are there to ease the installation of that circlip into the piston. But of course, as mentioned, they're not often there nowadays, and therefore it can be really tricky. And if you've tried it, you've more than likely found that they've gone flying across the room. You've either damaged the piston in the process, you've damaged the circlip in the process, or you've damaged yourself, most likely your hand. And let's just say you get that circlip into its recess, into its home in the piston. If you've done it slightly wrong, you've bent it just slightly, you've taken out some of that tension, it can very well let go when the engine's running. And as you can imagine, that can lead to a huge expensive repair bill in the process. And although manufacturers make a specialist tool to install the circlips, unless you plan on regularly rebuilding engines, it's probably not worth the investment. Therefore, in today's video, although I will show you how to use that OEM tool to install circlips, I'll also show you the method of installing them with nothing other than just a pick. And even with this, you can do it safely, you can do it effectively, you can do it without damaging the clip, the piston, or your hands, or having them flying across the room. And I'll demonstrate it using this piston. Now, this one's scored, it's come out of a damaged engine, so it can't be reused, but it should serve as a good training aid, and it'll allow me to get a really close-up view with the camera. So firstly, we align the circlip so that one end sits in the groove and is positioned such that the other end comes just past the recess in the piston. Next, we're going to place our thumb at the halfway point along that circlip, and that's to secure it in place and to help stop it from flying out. Then we're going to take a small pick or pointed tool and place it in the groove under the circlip's open end. And note that on rare occasions, if your piston doesn't have this notch machined in, you can carefully Dremel one in, both to install and to remove those clips. And then the last thing is to simply lift that pick up and push it inwards, and the circlip will slide down and into its groove. You should hear a click. And if you don't, look closely and just make sure that it's fitted in the groove all the way around. And if not, take that pointed tool and gently press it in. It's important to remember to keep your thumb at that halfway point, and it may require a gentle bit of persuasion with your thumb to get the whole clip in its recess. And the last thing that so many people do wrong is they forget to align that circlip so that the open end is facing either up or down and not horizontal. And the reason being that we have that open end either facing up or facing down is if we were to have it horizontally, as the piston is moving up and down in the engine, there's so much force that it can actually compress that spring slightly and it can come out. As you can imagine, if that was to happen, the top end will be destroyed, both the cylinder, the piston, and the rings as well. And although it works really well to install the circlips in this way, if you plan on repeatedly rebuilding engines, it really might be worth considering investing in the OEM tool. And as mentioned, it makes the process so easy, so quick. It takes out all possibility for that circlip to go flying, for you to damage or scratch anything, and it really is a repeatable way of doing the process. I have a Stihl OEM tool. Now, you don't have to use Stihl. You can go to so many different manufacturers. Find the one that suits you, suits your machine, and the right size for the circlips that you're going to install. The Stihl tool that I'm going to be using here is actually made up of two parts, so I'm going to refer to them as part one and part two, just so it makes sense for you guys at home. So the first thing we want to do is to lightly lubricate part one, the channel, the bore inside that tool. And you can use any light machine oil, it really doesn't matter, but don't use a grease, it is a little bit too thick and it's not really necessary. The next step is to align the open end of the circlip with the flat section of part two. Now that's magnetic, so actually gently press that circlip in place and it will stay there. Then from here, you're going to press the clip into part one until it's fully home. And this compresses the spring and it sets the alignment for installation. So from here, you align the other end of part one against the piston. take part two and press it all the way in until that circlip rides down the inside of part one and it will fall into its recess and it will be seated just as it should. And it really is that simple, but there are a few rules that I stick by every time I install circlips. The first one is to install one of the circlips, and ideally the one that has less access when the piston is on the connecting rod, into the piston while it's off the engine. This means that you don't have to fight it at a later date, and you only need one side to assemble that piston anyway. Secondly, I recommend that you never reuse these circlips, and they are literally a dollar or two each. It's just not worth the risk for the saving. And as mentioned earlier, thirdly, always align the circlips open end vertically, so either at 12 or 6 o'clock, and this ensures it can't compress and pop out when the engine's running. When you buy the clips in the first place, buy a few extra, a few spare to keep on hand. They're a very standard size, and it's more than likely if you don't use it for this rebuild, you can use it for future ones. And if they do go flying or they do go missing, then you've got some spare on hand and you don't have to wait a week for a new set to come in. And as mentioned, circlips will go flying. It's just inevitable when you're learning. Therefore, it's worth wearing safety glasses. Place a rag over the open portion of your crankcase as well. And you can even put a clear plastic bag over the piston, and that will allow you to capture that spring if it does go flying. Lastly, always use OEM circlips. Aftermarket clips aren't made to the same quality standards. They haven't got the same quality control. They're different sizes. The spring tension might not necessarily be right. And OEM circlips are some of the cheapest things that you can buy from the manufacturer of all the parts that you're going to be getting. So it's worth it. It just makes sense. And now that you've rebuilt the top end of the engine, like in this case a two-stroke, it's imperative that you pressure and vacuum test it. This is to ensure that there's an airtight seal, that it doesn't run lean, and it doesn't end up with a scored engine. And I've got this video here that goes over that entire process, and it only takes 4 minutes. I hope that video helps. I hope today's video helps. And until next time, I'll catch you soon.